suggest for you. Tonight is our first show after our summer break, so if people seem a little nervous, you'll understand why. Just For You is produced out of Monte Vista High School with the help of Chester Farrow and run totally by the students. Before we get into the show, I'd like to tell you about some upcoming concerts. At the Henry J. Kaiser Convention Center on October 10th is Motorhead. Tickets for Motorhead are $15 in advance, and the show starts at 8 o'clock. At the Concord Pavilion, we have two shows. First one is on October 11th, and that is Oingo Boingo. The second one is on October 17th, and that's Eddie Money. Both of these shows begin at 8 o'clock p.m., and they are both $15.50 for reserved. At the Shoreline Amphitheater is Rodney Dangerfield. Rodney Dangerfield is on October 18th, and the tickets are $17.50 for advanced. Now, if you could handle the fires, it's $15.50 for the lawn. And October 19th through the 22nd at the Oakland Coliseum is, yeah, Genesis. Genesis tickets are $17.50 in advance. Thank you. Now, here's the rest of our show.
It's Friday night. You're bored, and you don't know what to do. There are dozens of parties. You know, the kinds where drugs and or alcohol may be offered. But nah, you don't want to do that. And we here at Rainbow Studios wouldn't dream of it. So come along with us. We're going to the movies. The recently released box office smash, Stand By Me, based on the novel The Body, is about friendship and growing up. The movie, set in a small Oregon town in the late 50s, stars four young, cocky, foul-mouthed, cigarette-smoking boys. They were a gang in the summer of 59, led by the coolest 12-year-old in town, Chris Chambers. After the boys, Gordy, Vern, Teddy, and Chris secretly learn there is a dead boy about 20 miles out of town, they set off to find him. During their two-day journey, they learn things about themselves and each other that will last a lifetime. The movie is funny, sad, and full of suspense. It's a great movie which people of all ages should see. In fact, 10 out of 10 people polled who saw the movie said they loved it. So you see, there's proof. Instead of going to that party Friday night, go see Stand By Me. It's playing at a theater near you.
The cutting-edge progressive rock group The Smiths have recently issued their fourth album entitled The Queen Is Dead. Formed in 1982 by lead singer Stephen Morrissey, The Smiths take a new approach to music, singing about the way people live as opposed to the way they don't live. Morrissey expresses many pointed political views in his introspective writing style. In the title track, he disparages the pomp and circumstance of British royalty and England's fading glory. The Smiths have released two videos so far for this album, one for the thorn, Boy with the Thorn in His Side, and one for There Is a Light That Never Goes Out, which you are hearing right now. This song illustrates a rather tragic story, but the overall message is one of everlasting and undying love. The band lineup is Morrissey vocals, Johnny Marr guitar, Andy Rourke bass guitars, and newcomer Craig Gannon, formerly with Aztec Camera, and Mike Joyce on drums. The Smiths are not a flashy band. Their music is for real people, as it is about real life.
In the not-so-distant past, I read an article which was so horrifying I had to read it again, which is a rare occurrence for myself. It appears that the Reverend Pat Robertson is running for the candidacy of the Republican Party in 1988. For those of you who aren't familiar with Reverend Pat Robertson, he is the host of a daily Christian television program called The 700 Club. Personally, I believe the whole thing has been set up by the Republican Party to force Congress to repeal the 22nd Amendment, which would allow Reagan to run for a third term. I figure the longer Congress holds out, the closer that Reverend Robertson will get to the White House. It all seems so innocent. It's too easy. The entire thing is obviously a scam and will probably work. After all, what are the majority of white American voters? Paranoid? Finally, to get things straight, I'm not against any religious or fanatic cult, with the exception of the Mickey Mouse Club. And finally, even if Robertson did run, who would be his running mate? God?
Hi, kiddies. How would you like to have three-dimensional TV in your own home? Well, now you can for just $1 a day. Get hit by a foul ball. Get hit by a face of a foul ball when watching baseball. You can make Harry's day, you punk. Get shot by Don Johnson when you're watching Miami Vice. Just think of it, $1 a day for 3D TV. In your living room, remember, you will receive this handy-dandy 3D TV pen when you order your 3D TV today, so act now, you bozo.
Hello,
I'm here to give a TV review, and when I first got this job, I gotta say I was pretty thrilled, because number one, I had an excuse to watch TV, number two, I get to totally make fun of the show, and number three, and still get class credit. What more could a person want? But unfortunately, I decided to watch the show Moonlighting. Now, I also gotta say, I loved it. With Bruce Willis's winning smile and gorgeous blonde hair as Shippo Shepherd, these two are a real hot pair. The episode I watched was about a married couple, and the wife, like usual, has an affair, and the husband finds out. But when the husband struck the wife, she accidentally fell down the stairs and broke her neck. Around this time, you would figure the show's about over, but then a week after he killed her, the wife calls him. This is where the husband hires the Blue Moon Agency to find his dead wife. Here's a clip of the show now.
What happened to her? Where is she? Is she alive? You killed her, didn't you? And then you hired us to keep yourself from looking like a suspect. That's it, isn't it, Mr. Bauer?
No. I hired you because I think she's trying to drive me crazy.
Who's trying to drive you crazy?
Melissa.
You think that your dead wife is trying to drive you crazy?
I think so, yeah. I don't know. All I know is she was dead. I took her into the woods, I dug a grave, and I buried her.
And then?
She called me the next day.
As you just saw, the situation was very crucial, but Bruce Willis was able to make it a humorous one. So, if you have nothing to do on a Tuesday around 9 o'clock, watch Moonlighting. You won't regret it.
Hi. I've got a question for all you sports fans. True or false, an NFL game has never been canceled due to bad weather? I'll give you a while to think about that one. I'm not really here to do trivia. I'm here to do sports. So let's talk sports. This week, I'm going to address the NFL replay rule. The replay rule, which the NFL has been operating with since this season, has become a major pain. First of all, it's used a lot, and that means that it takes time out of the game. Second of all, it's not used on every play, so some bad calls have gone by. A couple have made the difference in the outcome of the game. What this all boils down to is that the present replay rule is a mess. From what I can see, the NFL basically has three choices. Number one, they can leave it as it is. Number two, they can get rid of it completely and go back to the way they used to do it. Or number three, they can modify the replay rule. Number three seems to be the best answer. A CBS poll showed that the majority of sports fans think instant replays should be used, but think that the rule should be changed. So comes the problem. How should the replay rule be changed? If the NFL can swallow its pride a little bit, it could learn from the USFL. The NFL's only competitor seemed to have a very good solution to the replay problem. It let the coaches have the option of questioning a call and requesting an instant replay. If the replay showed that the referee's call was right, then the contesting team had to sacrifice a timeout. If the instant replay showed that the call was wrong, the call was revoked. This system worked quite well. It even added a little suspense to the game. It proved to be an effective way of dealing with modern technology without disrupting the game. I sincerely hope that the NFL adopts a rule similar to that of the USFL so that the thing to watch at football games becomes football again. It really isn't very exciting watching a referee watch TV. That's all on the replay rule. Let's go back to that question. True or false, an NFL game has never been canceled due to bad weather? The answer is true. Pro football games are played no matter what the weather conditions are. That's all for sports. I'll see you next week.
Oh, hi, my name's Gwen.
And I'm Wen.
No, yeah, that's not right.
I'm Gwen.
And I'm Wen. And we're here to give you advice on...
on boys,
girls,
puppy dog tails,
and most important of all,
how to remove those unwanted spots from the ceilings.
Well, anyway, as you know, this is our first show, so we don't have any letters.
Because we don't have any to read.
So we have no advice to give. But if you write us, care of Gwen... and Wen. No, they can't see that. They have to see that. In care of Gwen and Wen, 3131 Stone Valley Road, Danville, California.
94526.
Oh, must be airmail. Do you want the honor?
No, you.
No.
Okay. How exciting.
Dear Gwen and Wen, ever since birth, I have always been different from other people. Last week, I underwent major reconstruction
of my...
You're right. You do have a problem.
Let's be our man.
I wonder if their wings are getting tired. You did the honor.
Okay. Dear Gwen and Wen, I am a young, insecure boy, and girls are starting to look not too good for me, or are starting to look good enough for me. That's what's up. I'm finding myself attracted to the same sex. I don't know what to do about this situation. Please help me. I need your advice.
Well, I remember when I was in fifth grade, and I was in love with that.
Tommy T. Used to like me so much.
No, he didn't. He was one who, you know, invited me to play dodgeball with him.
No, it was mean. It was too square.
No. We are being so rude. We're on the air. Sorry,
people out in TV land. Well, back to KJ's problem. Have you ever thought of getting some advice?
Yeah, you sicko. Who do you think we are anyways? Ann Landers or something?
Yeah. What do you think you look like, dear Abby?
Yeah. Well, we're not. I'm Wen.
And I'm Gwen.
And this is our show for this evening. And make sure you send in those letters. See you next week.
Bye.
Bye.
Parker Stevens.
Isn't this boy a bit of a brat? To him lie just a fling.
Finding Kappa first in his class. He treated just like a king. And he says,
I'm not sure what it is I must have, so I guess I'll just take everything. He's just ambitious. He's not a bad man. He's just ambitious. He's not a bad man, just ambitious. Oh yeah, just ambitious. Here is a young girl, born down and out, locked up in jail when she was 10. Yeah. Now in the courtroom, she's got a bit more clout. She sits on the judge side of the bench.
She's just ambitious. She's not a bad girl. She's just ambitious.
Hey, Marco, what are you doing here? It's the wrong studio. Old man over there. You told me to get back.
Oh, yeah. Just ambitious.
More and more students here at Monte Vista become musicians and form bands. Tonight, we're pleased to have with us one of the better bands at this school. I'd like y'all to welcome the up-and-coming thrash metal band, Crusader. This is Clay Haller, he plays bass, and Ted O'Neill, lead guitarist and lead vocals. Welcome to the show, guys. So, Clay, tell me, how did you guys meet?
Well, we pretty much met in junior high school, and a friend of ours got us together and we started jamming, and that's pretty much how it all started.
Yeah, all right. Ted, what inspired you guys to start playing thrash metal?
Well, I think thrash is something you have to want to do. It's like, it's not like something you just decide to do. It's pretty much for the aggression, speed, and violence of it all. Probably play thrash.
All right. Well, what type of bands are you guys influenced by, and what do you listen to?
We're pretty much influenced by Slayer and Venom. Just thrash metal, you know, complicated, but, you know, talented thrash metal music.
That's good. Right, well, do you have any plans for the future?
Yeah, we're going to stick around here for a while, play some clubs, and do our demo. And then maybe in about 2 years, we're thinking about doing an album. We're out of high school.
Well, where have you been playing, like, recently out here?
Well, we played at the MAB in the city and Rock on Broadway and just parties and just things like that.
Let's go. And are you going to play anywhere, like, recently? I mean, in the near future?
Yeah, we're playing at Monte Vista. We're playing here next Friday. And we'll probably be playing local gigs and then going back to clubs for a while.
All right, well, if you guys want to see Crusader live in action, then keep watching the show and we'll keep you posted on concert dates. And until then, thanks, guys. Ted, Clay, and drummer Danny say he couldn't be here tonight, so thank you wherever you are. And good night. Have a nice day.
From Danville, it's the evening stretch with Chris and Spencer.
Thank you. Good evening, and welcome to Evening Stretch. I'm Chris Cale.
And I'm Spencer Hansen, and again, we'd like to welcome you to the first edition of the Evening Stretch.
And I bet you they're probably wondering why we have bowls on our heads.
Well, we let Chris's mom, do our hair before the show.
And she kind of screwed up. We tried to fix it with tape. I don't think it worked that good.
I think it worked pretty good. I don't know.
It's pretty pathetic,
okay,
and we were the bowls at school today.
Okay.
Back to the show. Tonight we're going to be briefing you on a word that is commonly misused in the world, and especially in this great nation of ours.
64 years ago, our forefathers brought to this great nation of freedom.
This great nation of opportunity.
This nation of natural resources.
A common household word. And presenting this word to us tonight, it's the figure of the week, Felipe.
Felipe. Drum roll, please.
Lunch. Lunch, man. Lunch.
Lunch?
Lunch?
Lunch.
Lunch.
And here's here's Henry Kissinger asking Ronald Reagan if he'd like to.
Lunch? And here's Ronald Reagan's response.
Sure. Let's lunch.
Well, that's going to do it for the evening stretch tonight, but I hope to see you here next week.
Same place.
And I'd like to wish you...
Same time.
A good evening.
And enjoy your dinner.
I bet you they thought we were going to say lunch.
Yeah.
Fooled them.
Good evening. Are you looking for a new restaurant or a new kind of place to eat? Well, if so, and you're tired of the same old restaurant blues, I've got the place for you. It's a place called Burger Road. Burg Road is located at 1625 Contra Costa Boulevard in the Gregory Village Shopping Center in Pleasant Hill. On the outside, Burg Road looks like the rest of the stores around it, but this is where the resemblance ends. Inside, you'll find it's a unique restaurant with a cool, dark atmosphere and enjoyable people there. Burg Road has more than just food to offer. It has darts, chess, checkers, and other games available, so you can play them while you wait for your food to be prepared, so this is obviously not your average restaurant. My meal consisted of a very large cheeseburger, very well prepared, and a side of large French fries, which were made on the spot before my eyes. My burger was very well prepared, and exactly as I had ordered it, with everything on it. And they excluded nothing, and obviously, they did a very good job, as I enjoyed it thoroughly. So if you're looking for the place to eat, a new type of thing to do, Burger Road is the place to go, located at 1625 Contra Costa Boulevard, just across from Hogan's, in the Gregory Village Shopping Center. Thank you.
Hello, I'm here to tell you about what movies are out and what movies you can rent. Well, there's a bunch of them out there, but I finally found one that I'd like to tell you about. It's Monty Python and the Holy Grail. This movie is extremely funny. I hardly stopped laughing through the whole entire thing. I'd like to show you a clip from the movie, and in this scene, the Knights of the Round Table are about to cross a bridge. And before they can cross this bridge, they must answer three vital questions. Here's what happens.
Questions, Bridgekeeper. I'm not afraid.
What is your name?
My name is Sir Lancelot of Camelot.
What is your quest?
To seek the Holy Grail.
What is your favorite color?
Blue.
Right, off you go.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. That's easy!
Stop! Who approaches the bridge of death must answer me these questions three. The other side, he see.
Ask me the questions, Bridgekeeper. I'm not afraid.
What is your name?
Sir Robin of Camelot.
What is your quest?
To seek the Holy Grail.
What is the capital of Assyria?
I don't know that.
This scene is only the beginning. I promise this movie will have you laughing. There's a few other Monty Python movies, like The Life of Brian. You ought to check it out. And you know if it says Monty Python, it's got to be good.
Hello, this is Vinny Toledo.
And this is Kevin Morrow.
And this is
The News.
Today in the news, a scandal took place at Monte Vista High. It consisted of a group of people selling raffle tickets to freshmen for $2 apiece, claiming that there was a 300ZX for the first prize. Many freshmen were involved in the purchases of these counterfeit tickets. It's been brought to our attention that $3,000 was made. Coincidentally, $3,200 today was added to the senior class funds. To you, Kevin.
Thank you, James. Today's cover story is a valuable lesson from the smoking section, how to hold a cigarette. I know, most of you out there are thinking that there are many different ways to hold a cigarette, but this is not to be. I have learned many different techniques from the smoking section's representative and also my close friend, Rabbi Fulton's. First, there is the two-finger hold, like so. Then the three-finger hold, and last but not least, the wannabud hold, for all of those who can't afford the real stuff.
Oh, thank you, Wendy.
That was our correspondent, Wendy Tokuda. Wait a minute. We've got a special bulletin here. What's this? The smoking section at Monte Vista High will be closed starting on January 1st? This law will affect every school in the state. Well, James, I'm sure that there's going to be a big protest on this issue.
You bet.
Yes. So, we will keep you updated on the situation. Thank you, and back to you, James.
Tonight, on Who's Who, Colonel Muammar Gaddafi is the subject. After a pretty much hide-and-seek routine, everyone wants to know where he is. Well, we think we found him. It appears that he is here. Well, that's the news for tonight. I'm Vinny Tolito.
And I'm Kevin Morrow.
See you next time on the news.
Well, that's a show, and we hope you enjoyed it. If you have any comments, questions, or suggestions, please feel free to write us, and we'll be sure to answer your letters. You can write to us at Rainbow Studios, care of Monte Vista High School, 3131 Stone Valley Road, Danville, California, 94526. Be sure to tune in next week when we will be featuring our female mud wrestlers. But until then, have a great weekend, and we'll see you next week.
I'll just believe it, that tomorrow never comes. I must believe in something, so I'll make myself believe it. This night will